Yeah.
Where it feels like it's cooking us alive underneath the bridge and we're hiding with the digits.
Yeah.
Digs.
Probably, for the calzone, it probably varies, but...
Probably 15 minutes.
I don't think it takes them too long, because remember, when we're there, they pull pizzas out of the oven pretty quickly at Cosmos.
Yeah. That's true. Yeah, that pizza oven is hot.
Well, they're coming back with some speed.
I think they're going to go grab that yellow boxcar.
Maybe.
Center beam.
We might. Good job on correcting yourself of knowing which one you were talking about.
Well, as I was looking at it, I realized.
Yep. You're learning. Again?
I like the chatter.
Me too. I don't know if you can see it, but do you see the hostler over there pulling out?
I do. With the flashing light on top?
Yep.
Yep. As soon as you said that, it popped out.
Yeah. I was kind of watching them the whole time.
I think everybody really loves you here.
Yeah, they love seeing us here.
They've come. Yeah, they went to go get that first center beam and have an eye on. I get lucky when I pick the right one.
The remote's got an entire stack of center beams behind him. Some are loaded and some are empty. I knew it.
There it is.
Yeah, all the same time.
Yep, there's the Zephyr. Yep. Oh, that's cool. Going to love the scene I just captured. That was cool.
I had the camera trying to keep the swarm over as far as I can, but these guys are still in shot, and they're definitely zooming by on the other side.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah.
Cruising through.
Yeah. I see the RCO walking around.
Yeah, I was like,
there he is. I can see his feet. There he is.
Thank you.
Well, you're right. Oh, he climbed on.
blinking red light there. And of course, you can see the time code.
Yeah,
time code.
By Cabela's, would you buy yourself a new hat?
No, we got two brothers sitting in the house. But I meant to grab one. Because I was looking at them yesterday when we got home. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pretty amazing.
That's not it. The zoom isn't even run in all the way. But I can catch him all the way down there. He is. You see the shadows?
The air is coming up on the rear there, Green River. Great stuff, man. Thanks.
Thank you. think that's exactly what they're doing. Is that rack over there is where they keep them.
Yeah, that's right.
Or maybe they're going in to get a coffee. Tell what he's doing with his last few.
They'll probably cut the two lights since they're loaded.
Looks like, I think that's exactly where he's going. Yep. That was the exact pin he was reaching for. Is that high roller? Got him? Oh, it doesn't look like that. There he goes.
Yep.
Need a little extra hard push.
Yeah.
560 forward. Move over.
Pushing up for the next one.
Yeah,
I'm always amazed at the whole radio control concept. Why?
Okay, well, thank you.
Do you like how I describe it, how they're like life-size Lionel trains?
Yeah.
It's about the best way to describe the system.
It really, really is.
Because if you remember, the West Hump is at Bailey is side by side.
Let me check.
The East is an in-line yard. Like it.
I asked Matt before we left, Matt Wallace.
Pretty focused on that red line.
I mean, we can drop at Rolla, we just want to make sure we do it at the right place.
Exactly. Well, it looks like exactly where he's heading. And, go check with the other managers here, over.
And you can see the high rail going down, too.
We'll hear from you.
Looks like he's parked.
Yeah.
For whatever reason.
Yeah, so the track he's on, I think, is the last track before it gets over into the departure side. So this might be the last bit of work we see this morning before they shut, before they put that set away. That's the high railer that went by. That's the high railer that went by earlier.
Yep.
No worries. I'm always here to help you. Can't tell if the locomotive is moving.
The RCO?
Yeah. Doesn't. Oh no, he is. He's going backwards. Yeah, he's going backwards. I can see the track in front of him getting longer and longer.
Oh yeah. And now I see exhaust coming out of the stack. He might be dropping off some of those cars.
Yeah, and the high railer, I can see him off to the other side. He's got his tailgate open and he's looking around at something. Well, he's moved quite a distance in the last few minutes.
I want to see the picker load up these well cars.
Well, we might see it show up soon, because these are in line for...
Yeah.
I think these are in line for loadout. Oh, look at it.
Yeah, because that's the track where they load, isn't it?
Yeah.
I hear you loud and clear, Captain.
Hey, hold. I've got that on video.
Yeah.
You'll probably hear me laughing like crazy when I get to that part.
I heard you laughing this morning. You know, I was sitting down the stairs. I didn't want to come up because I know sometimes if I come up when you're not ready, I startle you. I was like, yeah, I'll just wait down over here as opposed to the kitchen. Because I didn't want to turn on the light for Robin and Sydney sleeping.
I forgot they were at the house.
They don't make a lot of ruckus.
Nope.
I didn't even hear them come home. Did you?
I didn't.
Did?
I didn't.
Oh, didn't. There weren't any Oreos in the kitchen, probably.
Yeah, he is. Still has all those end-of-train devices on the back of that truck.
It's like he's wearing a jacket with fringe. So they're on the front of that.
There's one. I thought there were two as well, but there's one standing on the nose. Up on the front walkway. And then he stopped on the turnout. Oh, now he's moving again. No, it looks like he's light. Yeah, he's light. There's nothing on him. Yeah, he dropped that entire setback. I don't know where he'll go now. Yep. Now he's going somewhere else.
Yeah, he'll be back because you see the one guy still standing at the switch.
Yeah.
So he'll be back because he's grabbing something. I don't think he'd leave him stranded at the switch.
Right, remember, if that guy needed to, he could call the locomotive back to him because he's got a remote. Looks like he's got a hopper car and a tank car, and that's it. He's just like, here, let me go grab two things and I'll be right back. He literally only has two cars. Do you see that?
I do. Sometimes the little things are need to get taken care of the little details.
Exactly. Like, think of the locals that we see moving out of here on occasion.
Yep.
You know how I've seen locals leaving before?
Yep. It'd be fun if you came through the local with the caboose.
Yeah, that's how you know it's going to be a local move. If they've got the caboose on it. Because remember, the caboose is the shove platform for this yard. This yard and 36, they both.
They share it.
Oh yeah, there he goes. I guess I didn't see him the first time, then climbing on. Yeah, they let go of those two, and now we'll probably go get whatever's next. I'm using reference of that green switch stand.
Yeah.
I always try to use a fixed object for reference.
Makes sense.
Either the switch stands or these trash cans that are sitting here. Weird. Somebody asked me in a video a few months ago, why are there trash cans up here? Like, why are there trash cans positioned all around the yard? And it's like, wouldn't you want to keep it clean?
Yeah,
all the grime and dirt. And one thing someone comments every now and then is the condition of how bad the tracks are right in front of us here. Yard tracks are a lower priority because it's a lot of smaller movements over them.
Yeah.
I mean, they're more frequent moves, but they're shorter.
Right. Yeah, we'll try. I'll stop you just here.
It's probably going to be one they're going to have to break in two in order for it to fit. They're probably going to pull ahead to a distance, break it, and then roll back to put the second set away, and then the remote will take over on breaking them apart. Yeah, they pull up about the 48th Street abutments, they pull the couplers, he tells them to roll forward, air hoses pop apart, and then they pull the rest of the train up, they'll knock the other section back next to the first half, unhook the engines will do their little shimmy through the tracks, and then roll into the pit. That's using very basic terms there, nothing there is very technical. Yeah. I try not to be super techie about it for you because you're not as versed in this as I am. I also try not to do that too often because some people are like, what the hell are you talking about in the video? It's going slow. That is a very long train that he's pulling. Excuse me. It's always when the yard gets quiet that a through train or a freight train is going to pull in and drop off something. That's always how it goes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Stay busy.
Exactly. If this yard would... I was going to say, if this... You can see that the two units behind 5602, 6583 and 6635 are slightly newer engines. On those engines that you can tell they're a slightly newer type. I heard something. I don't know if this is the train, but I heard something.
Thank you. intercept the guys that followed us all the way here. Yeah, I think so.
That's kind of nice, because that's pretty hard to miss.
Hey, DJ, that'll do.
don't hear your shot in.
You're good. It's pointing over there.
I know. I just didn't. I never know.
I know. Remember that one time?
Yeah.
I still laugh about that. You can either laugh or cry. Oh, we climbed off.
That'll do, GJ, when you get stuck. Far enough.
And there we go. Pretty smooth movement there.
Yeah.
It's amazing how steady they can be on the controls. I'm always impressed by that.
Yeah. A lot more steadiness on these roadies that come in than when they're just whipping around the cars getting them sorted.
Well, I mean, at the same time, the RCOs that run the sorting here, they also have to be gentle because you can break something.
Right, and I think
and if you bust up draft gear or a coupler or stuff like that, that's not going to be easy to fix.
It's probably also harder to do it with an RCO.
Well, I would think it'd be harder on these road ones because they're bigger. There's just more mass.
I see your point of view.
I mean, still, a train is a train, and it's not lightweight. Trains are not built for lightweight operations. Yeah, I'm pointing back over into the yard, so you're fine where you're standing.
Yep. Wasn't sure if you were going to swing back.
Good,
nope. Yeah, I'm not going to be swinging back for a while until the locomotives show up.
Let me know when you got the rear. Okay. 50 bar, DJ, and stop in the clear.
Okay, you can see the guy walking with the shove.
HGNY utility has you up to the ground in flat track. You're good for 60.
It's kind of like when we watch the guys walk, the RCOs walk alongside the engines as they're moving.
We're going to 4 track, Jeff. The 4 track, you're in 4 track, HGNY. Good for 60. Okay, 2-4, so good for 60.
See how he's kind of having to lock it back into the back there, into the back turn. So the conductor's currently talking in here on the radio. See all the back.
About 7 or 7, TJ.
7 on this end, okay. Doing good for 35 back here, GJ White.
What?
Room for 35 on
it. Disappearing back there.
Yeah, well, he's going to shove it out to the back, shoving it into the back. And then once he shoves it back there, they're going to, the conductor's going to untie them. They're going to pull up and put them away into servicing.
Yeah.
It doesn't look like there's anything down at the car shop. I don't think we see anything down at the car shop today.
I agree.
Let's look. You can see it down there.
Straight down, doors closed.
Yep. Well, he stopped.
That's perfect, Eric. I saw you click it back on and him start to roll. I think he was waiting for you.
Stop out here in front of the tower and drop the tank off real fast.
So they pull the power and they'll drop this, and then once they drop this power off in the pit, we'll call it a day. Yeah, we were right on schedule. I'm looking forward to pizza. Still thinking about the breadsticks.
Jump over to 87 while you're doing that.
Definitely not salad.
I remember seeing this funny thing. It was like, add coconut oil to your kale so it's easier to scrape into the trash.
Yeah.
It's like, good lord. Here he goes. This hole turned out pretty much perfectly. I wonder how much footage I'll have this
probably yesterday. Another hour today.
Yeah. Yesterday was a long one. Yeah, I think he's going down to change tracks to get to the pit.
Gonna go a little ways down to do that.
Yeah, I think it's just, I think the pit access track is just beyond, the switch for it is just beyond I-70.
It's amazing how quiet that is. Lions played today, the 49ers.
Yeah.
The winner of that game goes to the Super Bowl.
Let's hope the Lions take care of business and get another win under their belt.
I hope so. One of the guys.
It's not going to be a hope, but they will.
That's my plan.
I'm not going for hope. I'm going for it. They will win.
I like your attitude.
Because knowing how good they've been doing.
Yeah.
You going to watch the game with any of your buddies?
Nah, I was planning on just watching, but if the girls are in the house and all that, maybe we could go watch and eat somewhere.
Alright. Here comes.
Yeah, see
you. I always forget you can get in so many car holds.
Yeah, I think you just zip them over your regular clothes.
Yeah. So obviously in this environment, you gotta wear long pants.
What's that?
You gotta wear long pants.
Yeah.
Go. very well. But if you look on 3635,
yeah.
You see that kind of cutout around the cab?
Yeah.
That is the separation between the cab and the rest of the locomotive chassis. So it's on the cab is on shocks.
Yeah.
And that's why you can also see that little notch kind of in front of the...
You know the whole crown shape?
Yeah. But yeah, that's why there's the two doors. You have the first door you walk into,
yeah.
And then you walk into that second one in the isolated section. Because remember, the cab is isolated from the rest of the frame. It sits on like a shock absorber. And it isolates it from those exact shocks from like the vibration of the engine. Does that make sense?
Watch him give the hand signal and keep going about it.
Yep. Yeah, by like 3.5 hours. Like two and a half. Two and a half hours. I know what you mean.
I locked up.
Yep. Just kind of following him into the pit.
Oh, yeah.
Let's start packing up in a second. All right. Oh, no, he's still going. I thought he stopped.
Big. Unlike the working RCOs, when that thing went by, I could feel it rumbling in my feet.
So could I. Although when the locomotives, like the small ones, pass by, like on these tracks right in front of us, sometimes we feel it.
Yeah.
Remember, sometimes we also feel it when the RCOs go by, when they're running at like notch six.
Yeah.
The amount of energy that they emit. And that's also having to do with the 48th Avenue Bridge. It's just the vibrations get amplified among the concrete.
Bye-bye, locomotives.
It's almost there.